any short circuit in the output area, the feedback will disable the pulse width modulation. There is a short circuit. So when there is a short circuit, the feedback will go maximum and it will turn off the power supply. Okay, suppose this capacitor is short. It is trying to turn on again and again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Haseeb Electronics. हसीब इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स में आप सबको खुश आमदेद, वेलकम जी आया नो। मुझे सबसे पहली बात बहुत खुशी है कि आप सब लोग मेरी वीडियोस देखते हो, पसंद करते हो, मुझसे सवाल करते हो। टुडे आई गॉट अ मैसेज फ्रॉम सर संतोष मिश्रा जी एंड माय वेरी रिस्पेक्टेबल फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान एंड इंडिया एंड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। I received message from America, Philippines, Indonesia, Russia, France. So I have to continue my video in English as well. So if anyone feels bad that I am not speaking Urdu or Hindi, so I will apologize. But for my Indian brothers, for my Pakistani brothers, for my Bangladeshi brothers, I also upload videos in Urdu language. मैं अपने पाकिस्तानी, इंडियन, बांग्लादेशी भाई के लिए उर्दू में वीडियोस अपलोड करता हूं, जो कि हसीब इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स उर्दू में हैं। मेरे दूसरे चैनल का लिंक आपको मेरी वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में मिल जाएगा। आप मेरी यही वीडियोस वहां पे भी देख सकते हैं उर्दू लैंग्वेज में। हसीब इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंग्लिश चैनल है, वहाँ पे मैं इंग्लिश में वीडियोस लोड करता हूँ। उर्दू के लिए आप मेरा दूसरा चैनल विज़िट कर सकते हैं। आज मेरे पास ये एक SMPS है। इस वीडियो की स्पेशल मुझे डिमांड आई है, सर संतोष मिश्रा जी हैं इंडिया से, उन्होंने स्पेशल मुझे कहा है कि जी अशरफ भाई, आप फ्लक्चुएशन के बारे में कि अगर पावर सप्लाई फ्लक्चुएट करती है तो उसके रीज़न और उसके असबाब और फीडबैक सर्किट पर एक प्रैक्टिकल वीडियो बनाएं। पहले मैंने एक थ्योरी वीडियो बनाई है और बड़ी सब लोगों ने पसंद किया, और अनलकीली मेरी एक प्रैक्टिकल वीडियो मेरे एक दोस्त ने उसको डिसलाइक किया, सिर्फ इस वजह से कि मैं उर्दू नहीं बोल रहा था। लेकिन नो प्रॉब्लम, आई अप्रिशिएट, आई एम थैंकफुल फॉर दैट ब्रदर कि उसने अपनी लैंग्वेज से मोहब्बत की। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। आई हैव दिस पावर सप्लाई SMPS switch mode power supply that is used IC 5L0380 IC, any number, forget that, 0380 is generic number। so इस IC को use करते हुए हम इस video को complete करेंगे। इसमें हम feedback का तस्करा करेंगे और output में अगर fluctuation हो रही है, voltage regulated नहीं है, तो हम देखेंगे। Now I will connect power and we will see the fluctuation and the feedback and the switch mode power supply's action. So let's start. I have when we discuss fluctuation, that means there is no regulation in the output, because these power supplies are to be regulated. These are very nice and they have intelligent system that is called PWM, pulse width modulator, and if it is not making a correct regulation, what we will do? Ye power supplies, switch mode power supplies fully regulated hoti hain. Agar regulation nahi ho rahi to hum dekhenge ki aisa kyun ho raha hai. Thoda sa general jaiza main aapko batata hu. Ye dekhiye, to yahan pe hamari power supply mein hai kya? यहाँ पे इनपुट वोल्टेज है, यहाँ से एक लाइन फ्यूज से होते हुए, EMI फिल्टर से होते हुए, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन फिल्टर से होते हुए ब्रिज रेक्टिफायर में जाएगी, और NTC से होते हुए, नेगेटिव टेम्परेचर कोएफिशिएंट रेजिस्टेंस से होते हुए इस कैपेसिटर को चार्ज करेगी। वी मस्ट हैव रेगुलेटेड वोल्टेज ऑन दिस कैपेसिटर। इफ़ वी हैव फ्लक्चुएशन ऑन दिस वोल्टेज, आवर पावर सप्लाई विल नेवर बी रेगुलेटेड। First of all, for checking, connect power. I connected power and check the output voltage. If I have output voltage and they are stabilized, then okay. If I don't have voltage stabilized, what we will do? Now I will start my subject and I will put fault this IC 50, any IC. If you are using this one, if you are using 321, any IC, check the feedback pin. Feedback pin here is pin number 4. So in this circuit, the pin number 4 is the rightmost pin here. This is pin number 4. So I will connect my oscilloscope at pin number 4. We will compare the both pins. Pin number 4. Return line. This is a return line. And I will connect. I connected pin number 4. And I connected. Now I will connect pin number 2. I connected pin number 2, that is the drain. Okay, first of all we will see the circuit. Pin number 1 of this IC is connected to capacitor ground. The positive voltage, negative terminal of this capacitor, the main capacitor, negative terminal inner side, that is connected to pin number 1. Pin number 1. And pin number 2 is connected through this load resistor to the transformer for drive. Pin number 1 of transformer is connected to capacitor positive terminal, negative terminal is connected to pin number 1, pin number 2 will drive. Pin number 3 is VCC, that is very important pin for this IC. We have to check the voltage here also. And pin number 4, that is feedback, that is connected to the optocoupler output. So let's start. What I did, I connected this green line to channel 1, yellow line to channel 2. We will monitor the feedback and I will connect the input of the optocoupler. What response we will find in the short circuit, in the fluctuation, what we will find at optocoupler, we have to discuss this. So when you are working, if you have a fluctuation in the output area, now I connected. If you have fluctuation in the output area, then you will check the input of this optocoupler, or you can monitor the pin number 4 or feedback, any IC, any IC. This is not particular to this IC, it's a conceptual, it is a concept. Now I connected and now I will power on. Bismillah. We can see I have 2.4 volt in this optocoupler and I have a feedback. Okay, and so now we can see the switching. When I will put some load, now I will connect a resistor. The slight change will appear in the voltage. .001 volt. Okay. And the regulation will start, the pulse width modulator will start. And if we have a permanent short circuit in the output, we can see the IC is trying to power on Here it is working. Here we can find the feedback at the pin number 4, and if I have short circuit, the feedback goes high. The input of optocoupler will go 0. I have short circuit. When any component is short, we cannot find the output. At this optocoupler, you will find a varying voltage. And if there is any component short other than the main supply, now we will check. I can say I have this diode short. Check the voltage. If I have this diode short, see, the feedback goes low due to high current. If I have the voltage short circuit at any component, if I have this component short, this diode short, no function will happen. The power supply will try to power on, which we can see the fluctuation. This, if any diode is short in the output area, if I have this diode short, we can see it will try to power on, but it cannot power on, it cannot work properly. If this diode is short, we have fluctuation. Any component short in the output area or any load is making short, you cannot find the voltage, the output voltage will fluctuate. We can see it is fluctuating. If this diode is short, the power supply is trying to turn on, and the feedback, we can see the feedback go to maximum and it will disable the IC. It will try to turn on again and again and again. Just one second. Now I will show you more. We can see it is jumping now. Now it will become more clear. Yes, now it is more clear. Here we have feedback. Here we have feedback. And here is a load. It's now more clear. And now I will put load at any of the supply. We can see the feedback. The feedback goes high. When the goes high, the switching, SMPS switching changes. Okay, now if any component, suppose this diode is short, it is trying to turn on. Now we can see very correct. Yes, it's very clear. When any component have problem in the output area, the SMPS will try turn on and again this power supply, and we have fluctuation. We have fluctuation. Any component in the output area, if I have short circuit, we will find this problem. This time we are taking a good feedback and the IC is working properly. And pulse width modulation, here we can see the pulse width modulation. If we have short circuit, we can see there is a short circuit. So when there is a short circuit, the feedback will go maximum and it will turn off the power supply. Now the power supply, the pulse width modulator is trying to on, and we have a hum sound. We have a sound here. I will try to if you have this sound. If you have a whistle, like a whistle sound, then there is short circuit in the output. We can see if you have a permanent hum, that time we have some problem. So when you have fluctuation in voltage, you have to check the components. Okay, any of the capacitor in the output area, I will make jumper for, if this capacitor short circuit, this, okay, if this capacitor is short, we have the same symptom. Any component short in the output area, any component short in the output area will make the same problem. We can see if we have any short circuit in the output area, the feedback will disable the pulse width modulation. So IC will try again and again, turn on again. When it is working properly, we are finding the proper feedback. Okay, suppose this capacitor is short, it is trying to turn on again and again. Anytime if we have a fluctuation in the voltage, the power supply is trying to on off, that time we have short circuit in the output area. Or if the input capacitor, main capacitor, is bad, this capacitor is open. If it is short, it will damage all the input area. If it is open, the same situation will here. That time we will take voltage, but this time it is going on and off. But if this capacitor is open, if this capacitor is open from inside, that time you will find voltage a slighter, very little difference. Maybe the standard voltage are 5 volt, you are taking 4.5 volt to 5.5, the voltage will start varying. If power supply is trying to on and then off, that time we have problem short circuit in output area. If we have fluctuation, there is a VCC capacitor of pulse width modulator IC, this one, if this is open from inside, or it is disconnected or bad connection, you will find fluctuation in the output. If this capacitor is short from inside, you will not find anything. So I think this video is good for you. If this video is good for you, give a like. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.